In the late 1970s, Jane Barnes had just launched a business designing men's clothing.
When I started my business in 76, I was doing fabrics the old-fashioned way, just on graph paper, weaving them on a little hand loom.
But then she discovered fractals and realized that the simple rules that made them could be used to create intricate clothing designs.
I thought, this is amazing. So that very simple concept, I said, oh, I can make designs with that. But in the 80s, I really didn't know how to design a fractal because there wasn't software.
So Barnes got help from two people who knew a lot about math and computers, Bill Jones and Dana Cartwright.
I had Dana and Bill writing my software for me. They said, oh, your work is very mathematical. And I was like, it is? That's my weakest subject in school.
We had a physicist and a mathematician and a textile designer.
We had so much to learn from each other.
I did not know what a warp and a weft is. You know, Jane, her ability with numbers is fairly restricted, if I can put that politely.
All the parameters here, there was a way we were going to communicate. We were going to get together somehow. And it really did happen pretty quickly. The general fashion press thought, Jane's a little nuts. They started calling me the fashion nerd, you know, but that was okay. That was okay with me because I was learning a lot. This was fun and very, very inspirational. I'm getting things that wouldn't be possible by hand. You know, sometimes when I think about things in my head and I say, you know, I just saw light coming through that screen door. And look at the moiré effects that are happening on the ground. Can I go draw that? No way. But I can describe that to my mathematician.
This is kind of reminds me of...
He sends me back the generator, all ready for me to try. And I sit down at the computer and say, well, let's see what it's doing. And I have parameters that I can control. And I keep pushing, and I go, wow, this is not what I expected at all. At all, but it's cool.